Hey guys, Doom from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Amphibia Season 2, Episode 13, titled Ivy on the Run and After the Rain. Now, I think this description is a little backwards, but I'm going to read it as it is. Hop Pop's secret is revealed, and Ivy runs away. Also, before we get started, apparently, based on everyone else's reaction series, I reacted to the last two episodes, number 11 and 12, out of order. Because apparently, the shut-in was, like, released partway through the hiatus between episode 10 and the return to Waltwood. Well, Night Driver's return to Waltwood. Apparently that one was after the hiatus, so why they're switched on Disney Plus, I have no idea. Anyway, let's get this episode loaded up and started in 3, 2, 1, go. There we go. I'm excited to get another Ivy-centric episode, because this is also probably a Sprig-centric episode. And I'm interested as to what secret is revealed. It's most likely going to be the music box. That's the only secret I can think of, but you never know. Hop Hop, he might have other secrets. It's probably something just not important to the story at all, based on how this show sometimes goes. So, we'll just have to wait and see. Ivy on the Run. Okay, this is the first part. Ooh, it's a shiny. So is that like a hive mind bug? Is Wally going to be a natural? Polly seems more like she'd be into kickboxing. I could not live with a mum like that. Hibiscus matcha. They're going to come to some compromise. How do you sweep the leg of something that doesn't have legs? Why do you know? What? No, it's not. You're gonna get your ass handed to you. Well, for one, don't announce your attacks. traveling tea salesperson. Really? We're doing Karate Kid. How did I not realize up until now? How did I not realize we were doing Karate Kid? Oh, Wally. I mean, you're not wrong, but still. That was a different episode. Number one, the music box. It's made of twigs, isn't it? Why do I have a feeling it's not in the hole anymore? I thought he was going to say, but first I was going to... Okay. Radio then. Why is your bag open? Probably a mole. Magpie works too. I'm well familiar with magpies. Oh, it's Tamatoa. Hey, it took Loggle's statue. Hey, look, his goggles are useful for something. One of them stole the whole elf's bookcase. I wonder what the talisman is. Radio. Is he though? Interesting. So now we know what happened to Sprig and Polly's parents, eaten by herons. I had a feeling that would come back with the fact that they were the ones that attacked the, who was the Toad Tower. I had a feeling they'd come back at least once. And now we know that they attacked Waltwood. Hate Sprig and Polly's parents. And Hop Hop blames himself for not being there. Even though if he had been there, he probably would have been eaten too. Or eaten instead. But yes, that was a very interesting episode. Look, I understand what it was going for. But it just didn't hit for me. So, like, that whole episode, like, once I realized they were going, what is it? Karate Kid. That's what I really, oh, this episode's actually good. And I understand what they were going for with After the Rain, but honestly, I don't think the characters that we've been given so far would act that way. Like, Sprig and Polly, no, that was fine, but Anne, I don't think the Anne that we've seen this season would have acted that way. Like, she would have at least heard him out. But also, Hop Pop's story about Sprig and Polly's parents. I'm surprised they knew that. Like, they remembered that, but I don't know. It just was missing something for me. And I don't know what that was. I don't think there were any new voices. I think it was just people that we know from around the town. So, I don't have to look up anyone. Let's see. There were additional voices. Nope. She voices Sadie Croker. He voices Captain Grimes, so there's no actual new voices in Ivy on the Run. Let's check After the Rain. Nope. No new voices in that one either, so yes. I guess that's gonna be it for this episode. Little disappointed in this. It just didn't hit the way I feel it should have, and I don't know how I could have been done differently to actually make it hit. But yeah, I know how they could have done it to make it hit is if Sprig and Polly didn't know the story. Like, they didn't remember that Hot Pop was away when that the Herons attacked. The fact that they didn't know he blames himself for it, that would have made it hit a little harder. But anyway, I'll catch you in the next one.